New real estate investors typically fall into three different categories. The first type are those who are brand new to real estate investing and they know absolutely nothing. The second type is the people who have been watching YouTube videos, maybe they've gone to some events, yet they still have not bought a house or taken action. The third type is the person who has maybe bought their first property or maybe a couple of properties, but they don't know how to take it to the next level. If you fit in any of those categories, this video is gonna help you get out of that and take it to the next level, regardless of where you're at. In this video, we're gonna go over the different roadblocks that prevent people from taking action and going to the next level. And we're also gonna talk about the different ways that you can start investing in real estate today. But more importantly, I'm gonna help guide you through those different ways to figure out what strategy is best for you. So with all that being said, let's jump into it. So if you're new to my channel, my name's Ryan Pineda. I'm a real estate investor here in Las Vegas. And at my company, we do over 100 deals per year with a mix of house flipping, wholesaling, and rental properties. I also recently started a real estate fund where we're buying a 334-unit apartment complex in Georgia. And I say all this to let you know that I've done a lot of real estate investing in all forms of real estate. And I know that for beginners, it can be very intimidating because there are so many different things that you feel you have to learn. There are so many different ways that you can invest in real estate. And quite frankly, it's just overwhelming when you start looking at real estate for all that it is. And so in this video, I wanna help you simplify that so that it can become a lot easier and you can become more focused on whatever it is you choose to do. So in order to get more focused, you first have to change your mentality when it comes to investing. Most beginners in real estate have what I call limiting beliefs. And honestly, even I to this day still have my own limiting beliefs that I struggle with. So just realize that if you're a beginner, you're not alone if you feel some of these things I'm gonna go through. And there are really five limiting beliefs that prevent people from getting started or taking it to the next level. The first limiting belief is not having enough money. Now, this is the limiting belief that really stopped me from getting started for at least 5 years. You see, I became a licensed real estate agent back in 2010. And at the time, I had no money, and so I figured there's no way that I could flip houses or buy rental properties. And it stayed that way until 2015 when I finally bought my first flip. You see, for those 5 years, I believed that I needed to save up hundreds of thousands of dollars in order for me to buy a house to flip. And if I couldn't save up the money myself, I figured that I'd need some rich uncle or friend or somebody who trusted me with their hard-earned money. And unfortunately, I didn't know where to look for that money, nor did I know any rich people who would fund me. And it wasn't until I started listening to the Bigger Pockets podcast that I realized you didn't need money. In fact, anyone could start real estate investing today without any money at all. And I became a believer of that when I read Brandon Turner's book on how to invest with no or low money down. At the time, I had no idea who he was. Now we're friends, so it's super cool. But his book helped show me that, hey, you shouldn't worry about money. That's actually the easiest part of real estate investing. If you can get good at finding deals, the money will find you. And in fact, with social media today, connecting with people who have money is now easier than ever. So don't let money be a limiting belief that stops you from getting in the game. The second limiting belief that I always hear is credit. Most people think that they're not gonna qualify for a loan because they have bad credit or they have credit card debt. And it's partially true. You may not be able to qualify for a normal conventional loan or even an FHA loan. And in fact, when I started flipping houses in 2015, I did not qualify for a conventional loan. And the reason was I didn't have 2 years of work history, and I also had maxed out my credit cards to buy my first deal. But despite having credits in the 500s and maxed out credit cards, I was still able to flip houses and get loans. And you might be thinking, that doesn't make sense. How'd you do that? Well, there are people called hard money lenders and private money lenders. And at the end of the day, they're not really concerned about your tax returns or your credit. They are most concerned about the deal. And if you have a really good deal, as I said before, the money will find you. So do not believe that you need great credit in order to do deals. You could have an 800 credit score and it's honestly not gonna help you that much. At the end of the day, deals are the name of the game. The third limiting belief that I always see is not having enough knowledge. There are a lot of people who will watch YouTube videos nonstop. They'll listen to all the podcasts, they'll read all the books, and they just still don't take action. And what's the reason for that? They just feel that they can never take action until they know every answer to every question. They wanna know every little detail of this business before they do anything. And I'm here to tell you, I still don't know every detail of this business. I still go into deals not knowing what I'm going to do. Like I mentioned before, I'm currently buying 334 units. I personally have never done that, nor have I ever raised money to do that before. So I'm going through two of these limiting beliefs right now. Am I gonna be able to raise enough money to buy this deal? And what problems am I about to go through that I have no idea are coming? Now, obviously, we're still doing the deal and we're very confident about it, but these are things that you're gonna have to consistently do as a real estate investor. You gotta constantly keep getting out of your comfort zone and trying new things that you've never done before. And so you're never gonna have all of the knowledge. And so if you're stuck in that stage of analysis by paralysis because you feel like you need to know more before you take action, stop it. Because here's the truth about real estate investing. You are going to learn so much more by actually doing it and making the mistakes than you are ever watching a YouTube video. I've put out some great YouTube videos and some great content, but it will never compare to what you learn when you actually do your first deal. So get over the belief that you've got to know all of this information before you get started. You don't. The fourth limiting belief is the fear of failure. There are so many people that are scared to lose money. They think they might not be evaluating the deal right. They think that a contractor might screw them. There are so many different ways that you can fail in this business that you have to just put all of those out of your mind. In fact, you gotta accept that you will fail. I've done hundreds of deals and I've lost money on some of those deals. I've screwed up projects and renovation. I've gotten screwed by other people and been in lawsuits. You are going to fail when you take a lot of action. But successful people know that failure is a part of growing. Nobody ever grew their business being perfect. They had to go through bumps on the road and learn from those mistakes in order to take it to the next level. And so for me, failure is just an opportunity to learn a lesson. And if I can learn that lesson and apply it to all my deals going forward, it's actually gonna make me more money. So get over the limiting belief of the fear of failure. The last limiting belief that I hear people have is that the market is too competitive. They think that there are no deals out there because there's so many people trying to get them. And that's just simply not the case. It's funny, people ask me all the time, Ryan, why do you give away all your secrets? Are you scared that other people in Las Vegas are gonna copy them and take your deals? And the truth is no. In fact, by me teaching other people how to do this business, I actually end up doing deals with them and making more money. And even with as much as we market and prospect for deals, we very rarely come across our competition. You've just gotta realize that there are so many houses out there that there's just no way I or anyone else can be on all of them. You're gonna make a lot more money collaborating with other people in your industry than you would if you just treated them as competitors and you never wanted to talk to them. And even in a competitive market like it is today, there are still a ton of deals out there. We're on pace to have our best year ever in 2021, even though there is a shortage of housing. And even when it's the opposite and the market is really cold, it makes it even easier to get deals because there is truly less competition. And so you're able to get deeper discounts and properties are cheaper. So don't worry about what the market's doing, what the competition is doing, or who the president is. It doesn't matter. You can get deals in any market. And that's the key to being a new investor, is getting over those different beliefs. 99% of people don't take action because one of those beliefs prevents them from doing so. So I'd love to hear in the comments below what your limiting belief was, because obviously it's not a limiting belief anymore because you now know it shouldn't be. Now, once you can get past your limiting beliefs, you're now able to start taking action and pick a strategy. So let's talk about the different strategies. So when it comes to real estate investing, there are three main things that people do: wholesaling, flipping, and rentals. Now, if you're one of the brand new people who have no idea about real estate investing, I'll briefly explain them. Most people understand what rental properties are. You're simply gonna buy a house and rent it out to somebody else. The goal for most property owners is that the tenant ends up paying enough rent to cover their mortgage and potentially make some cash flow. And in turn, if you buy enough of them, you can create enough passive income that could cover the lifestyle of your dreams. The book Rich Dad, Poor Dad made this concept famous of becoming financially free. So rental properties are great for that aspect. The second one I mentioned is flipping houses. Now, if you're watching this video, you've probably seen the HGTV show. You buy a beat up fixer upper, you get it fixed up, and then you go and sell it for a profit. Now, even though they make it seem quick and easy on TV, there's a lot that goes into it. You have to figure out how to find the deal, you gotta figure out how to finance it, then you gotta figure out how to fix it up. But if you do all three of those things, you can make a lot of money today. Whereas rental properties are not gonna really make you much money at all today. Those are more of a long-term play where you're gonna be just getting a small monthly check. So flips are great for quick money. But the third way to invest is through what's called wholesaling. And wholesaling is like flipping without having to actually buy the house or fix it up. All you have to do is find a really good deal and then sell the contract to another flipper or somebody who wants rental properties. And what you're able to sell the contract for is what's called a wholesale fee. And to give an easy example, let's say that you put a house under contract for $200,000. And you know that I would buy it for $220,000. Because even at $220,000, I know that I can fix it up and sell it for over $300,000. And I'm gonna make a really good profit doing it. But you as the wholesaler would have made $20,000 in that scenario. And if you're kind of skeptical of what wholesaling is, don't worry, I was too when I first heard of it. It seemed too good to be true. But I'll tell you, I've paid millions of dollars in wholesale fees to buy properties from wholesalers. And we have wholesaled ourselves and made a ton of money. So I love the wholesaling strategy. And it's usually what a lot of beginners are attracted to when they hear about it. And it's easy to see why. You can make quick money today by just finding a really good deal. You don't have the risk of having to buy it and fix it up and get it sold, hopefully months down the road. But I would actually disagree that you should just choose that right out the gate because you're new. I'm actually a big believer in learning to flip houses first and foremost. And the reason is by learning to flip houses, you're able to do anything in real estate investing. Think about it. If you want to flip a house, you've got to get good at finding deals. You've got to get good at raising money. And you have to get good at managing construction. And so as a house flipper, if I find a good deal, I still have the option to wholesale it. Doesn't mean I gotta go flip every house, but by having the skill at finding good deals, I can now have a choice. I can wholesale it if I want the quick money, I can flip it myself if I wanna make even more, or I could even hold it as a rental. If you ever wanna buy rental properties, you're gonna have to learn how to find good deals, you're gonna have to learn how to finance them, and if they need work, you're gonna have to learn how to do construction. Well, if you've already learned how to flip houses, that's the same skill set for rentals. The only difference is, instead of selling it for a quick profit, you're keeping it as a long-term cash flow play. And so that's why I think that people should learn how to flip houses from the beginning, because it opens the doors for everything else. I've seen a lot of people who try to get started in wholesaling and they have success, but then they never progress past that. They never flip houses, they never buy rentals, because they never learned how to do the other two aspects. They still can't raise money and they still can't manage construction. Also, the other problem with only knowing how to wholesale is that you gotta get even better deals than house flippers. Think about it, if you're gonna sell it to a house flipper, the deal has to make sense for them. And for you as the wholesaler to make your spread, you gotta get it for significantly less. And so that means you gotta get better deals than everyone else in order to make money. But if you were able to flip, you don't have to get as great of deals because you're gonna buy them yourself. Also, it gives you the ability to buy from other wholesalers. I have great relationships with wholesalers because we have bought so many deals from them over the years. But I always say, if they were able to actually flip themselves, they would probably double or triple their revenue every year. Because by definition, they have to leave meat on the bone in order for someone else to buy it. So to be clear, I don't have a problem with wholesaling. We still do it, we buy from wholesalers. But if you wanna be a complete investor and you want a quicker path to your first couple of deals, I think it's actually easier to flip because you don't have to get as good of deals and it opens up the door to work with more people like wholesalers and realtors. So if you're still with me, there's one other aspect to think about when you're just getting started, and that is thinking both short-term and long-term. I believe when you're starting out, you should be thinking about how to make money in the short term. Essentially, how do I flip and how do I wholesale as many houses as possible so I could build up my cash? This was my strategy starting out because I didn't have much money. I could not afford to tie up my money in rental properties because I needed that money to do my next deal. If you saved up $20,000 that you could either put into a flip or put into a rental, I would say put it in the flip 100% of the time. It took you a long time to save up that $20,000 probably, and the moment you go and throw it into a rental, you're out of cash. And then you're trying to save up to do another deal. Whereas if you put it in the flip and you potentially made another $20,000 or another $30,000, now you've got a lot of cash to work with that you could then use to flip some more or maybe spend some money on marketing to get more deals. Point is, when you're just getting started out as a beginner, cash is the most valuable resource you can have. So you don't wanna put it in things where it gets stuck. And I'll tell you, when I first got started with flipping houses, I did not buy a rental property for at least my first 50 deals because I was so focused on reinvesting my money into more and more flips because I wanted to build up my cash position. Now, here's the deal. You shouldn't always just be thinking of short term. Once you start building up your cash and getting experience, you then want to transition to thinking about the long term. How do I start keeping some of these properties as rentals? How do I start building up my cash flow and passive income? How do I keep these rentals to get tax deductions and appreciation? That stuff becomes important once you've figured out the short term. Now, I do have one exception to this rule. If you have a high-paying job that's making you multiple hundreds of thousands of dollars every year, you don't necessarily have to flip or wholesale. You could have enough active income from that job and start buying rental properties immediately. But if you're like me and you didn't have a high-paying job and you didn't have a career, then I want you to start off with flipping or wholesale, because building up your cash and an active income is more important. You can build the long-term wealth down the road once that's set in stone. Now, you might be thinking, Ryan, that's cool. I totally agree with you. I'm gonna get rid of my limiting beliefs. I know that I wanna get into flipping or wholesaling, but how exactly do I do that? Well, it would be way too much to cover in just this one video about how to do that. But you have two options. The first option is to go check out all of my videos in my real estate playlist here on YouTube. I've done tons of videos talking about how to find deals, how to raise money and get financing, also on how to manage construction, talked about how to find buyers if you want to wholesale. I've talked about Airbnb rentals. There is so much content that I've put out there completely for free if you want to take advantage of it. And even though those videos are great, you're going to have to sort through them and figure it out on your own after watching them. I believe option two will lead to much more success, and that is by joining one of our programs at Future Flipper. I have different coaching programs and courses that you can find at futureflipper.com. And we have over 1,000 students all across the country doing great things. We've had many who are just like you, who are brand new and who got their first deal. And then we have some who have made over $1 million in 1 year. And we have countless testimonials from all of these students all across the country. And the beauty with joining a coaching program is that you have the ability to have back and forth dialogue. If you have a question, you can get it answered by one of our coaches or the people in the program, or even me potentially. But it also gives you accountability to start taking action, and it gives you a community of other people just like you who are like-minded and who want to get started and take it to the next level. So if you're really serious about getting in the real estate game, I highly recommend scheduling a call at futureflipper.com. Someone from my team can walk you through which course or program is best for you in your current situation. And if you end up joining my All-Star program, you'll get to work with me personally, and I would love to help you get to the next level. In fact, one of my favorite things is when my students text me about big deals they just did or something new that they've never done before. But anyways, I hope that this video motivates you, hope that it shows you what's possible, and I hope that it inspires you to take those next steps, and most importantly, take action in your real estate investing career. And I hope that I get the chance to coach you. I'll catch you on the next video.